time to start playing it safe.
Son, you have to drop.
That's playing blues.
You gotta listen.
I've been listening to you my whole life.
You gotta put some pressure on.
How can a game have such an effect on man's soul? The way I see it, how can it not? You don't choose the game, it chooses you. And when it does, life and golf become forever connected. That's how it was for a young man named Luke Chisholm.
Got to be kidding me.
Out of the water there, you just continue to make the same mistake over and over again.
You hurt, son?
I'll get over.
Yeah. You the guy I saw putting the flag stick in the field?
Yeah, and you the guy that crashed through my fence?
Yeah. Help you. Yeah. Johnny Crawford's the name.
Luke Chisholm.
Yeah.
Yeah, let me see that. Yeah, okay. Right. Put a little pressure on it, it'll stop the bleeding, all right? Yeah.
Thank you.
I need to get you to my truck to get you some medical attention, all right? So let's get these clubs up here. You feeling all right? You're not dizzy?
No, I'll be all right.
You're a hell of a driver.
373 people.
375. Megan Monroe had twins last week. Yeah. Hadn't taken the sign down yet. That evening service just letting out. Hey, what you doing? I went this morning, in case you were wondering.
Oh, sir, I could use some more coffee.
Excuse me. What are you boys doing here?
You gonna save a dance for me tonight?
I'll think about it.
She's just playing hard to get. Of course she is.
Mom, it's Uncle Johnny.
Howdy, everybody. This here's Luke. He's had a small accident, but we have that aid kit back there.
Yeah, got him off.
Come on, what
in the world happened to this poor boy?
Where he's gonna live?
Mercy, looks like you've been hit by a truck.
More like a cow.
No. You hit a cow?
No, I missed the cow, but I did manage to run through the fence.
Do you need a doctor?
No, ma'am. I need a mechanic.
Here you go.
Thank you.
Sure.
We need some strong hands to get the car over to Brody's shop.
Jake, be a dear and help Johnny.
What about my burger?
Poor man's car just got wrecked, and you're worrying about a burger? How are your manners?
Come on, Jake, let's go. Let's go. Jake, come on.
Have fun.
Come on, Smiley. You too.
Come on.
Work some of that off it.
John.
Yes, sir.
Come on.
Come on, Chuck.
Go.
Yeah.
If I have Luke to the inn, I'd be much, much obliged. Thank you.
Sure. There you go. Just let me know whenever you're ready. Mom, we'll be right back.
Thank you, Mom.
Right here, back home. Are you right? Will this end in tears?
Where are you from?
Waco. But I've been on the road these past couple of years.
Yeah? Me too.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Well, what for? School?
I'm training to be a horse whisperer.
Well, I always thought horse whispering was only in the movies. So it's for real, huh?
Yep.
Well, good luck with that.
Thank you.
So where are you taking me anyway?
Oh, we're just going to River Inn. That's Uncle Johnny's place.
Are you two related?
No, he's just a close family friend, but I've always known him as Uncle Johnny. Here we are.
Well, thanks for the ride.
Right. Oh, going to get that man's after.
Don't you even think about coming in here with those. You must be the one who ran off the road. What'd you do? Fall asleep at the wheel? Well, come on. I don't have all day to check you in. Let's go. And close that door behind you. You're not bad looking. Blind as a bat, maybe. You married? The neighbor girl's looking for a husband.
No, ma'am. Not married.
Okay, now don't lose this key. It opens the front door, too, so you don't bother me when you drag in late.
Yes, ma'am.
There's extra towels in the cupboard there, but it's okay to use the same one twice. Breakfast is at 8. Don't be late.
With us here on Golf Central, I'm Todd Lewis, sitting beside Frank Nablo. And Frank, we begin with that unbelievable story happening at the Callaway San Antonio Open.
Well, that's right, Todd. Luke Chisholm is a name that we've all had on our radar screens ever since he won the Texas State Amateur Championship.
Folks, if you have not seen this highlight before, sit back and enjoy. It's something you will not forget. The winner of this tournament earns an exemption into the Valero Texas Open just a few weeks from now. Luke Chisholm had a one-shot lead on the final hole over Joe Buckner, Father Martin on the back, and look who shows up on the tee. The number one player on the planet and the tournament's lead sponsor, TKO. What an intimidating presence, Frank.
Well, that's enough to rattle anybody's cage. And in this situation, Luke Chisholm, he just blocks his tee shot way right. His dad, Martin, wanted him to get the drive.
3-iron.
Oh.
Not the time to start playing it safe.
Yeah, but if I make par, he's gotta make birdie to tie me.
Right now you're playing not to lose instead of playing to win. Here. Remember who won the Masters last year?
Well, that guy over there.
Yeah, that guy over there. TKO got his fourth green jacket.
Remember who come in second? Nobody remembers the runner-up, Luke. You can get on the green in two if you hit with a big stick.
Well, you want to hit a few? Your hand up to it?
Right.
Thread needle with 3-iron, you're bumping running up on the green.
Well, I think I should just punch out right here.
You got to put some pressure on. Hit the 3.
Hit the 3, huh?
Oh, Mom. There's an Easter egg hunt at the church tomorrow.
Sounds like fun. Can we go, Dad?
We got some practice to do tomorrow.
Martin, it's Easter Sunday.
Sunday's reserved for golf. Son, you have to drop.
That's playing to lose. You gotta listen to me. I've been listening to you my whole life, and this is where it's got me.
All right, where you gonna put it?
I hope you brought a snorkel.
All right, let's see what you got. Come on, man. You got to pull yourself together here, son.
Am I embarrassing you?
You hooked it. You got to watch your right hand.
There you go.
Let it release. Come on, now. Let's finish what we started here. Don't flip it. Come on, now. Come on, one more good one. Show me another one. Right now you're playing not to lose instead of playing to win. Nobody remembers the runner-up, Luke.
You gotta put some pressure on it. Hit the 3.
Jordy, he snaps his putter. Flings the shaft, and then the sad shot here. His father, Martin, walking away from son on the final hole. Oh, my goodness. He ends up shooting an 80 on the day. We're going to look at the one that started what I believe was the meltdown when he hit it in the hazard and going for it from there, Frank. What was going through his mind?
Well, I think he was still smarting, Todd, with the decision he made off the tee, whether to hit drive or 3-wood. That's obviously still in the back of his mind. And once you've made one mistake out of the water,
I had a feeling there was more going on than meets the eye.
Wow, you chill good.
You know, what could I have done differently? Instead, just hitting never gets you out of trouble. The problem is, his ball remains...
What I got to do to get some food around here? And this time to completely kill a cow myself?
So really, this is farcical. You've got no chance...
That's no greenskeeper.
PGA of America Half Century Club.
Be here. You can tote these. Well, close your mouth, sugar. Let's go.
Well, where are we going?
Better?
Yeah, I'm feeling better.
You're in good hands with Mabel.
Well, I'll tell you what, I'll feed you right, but it's my brother Johnny that you're going to get the most from if you pay attention. Now, where is my dance partner?
Sarah? Maybe you could just introduce Luke around.
Oh, sure.
Hey, are you feeling any better?
Oh, yeah. It's amazing what a shower and some clean clothes will do.
You good with this plane?
Yeah, go on.
Am I ever gonna get to see you whisper to a horse?
Oh, I don't do that just in front of anybody, you know.
What about dancing? You do that in front of anyone?
Hey, looky here, store boy.
Jay Creston, this is Luke Chisholm.
Yeah, we had the pleasure earlier today at the diner.
Yeah, that was right before I helped drag your car to the cow patty. Wasn't too happy about it at the time. Then me and Sarah saw you on TV, remember? You're a regular celebrity. Not every day I get to help out a record holder.
Hey, Jake, be quiet.
I had quite the meltdown.
Oh, yeah. I suppose you like that mud bath. Out of the golf channel, later miss a thing.
Jake?
It's okay. Just let him talk. I'm sure he could have done a lot better. You play golf?
Could hold my own?
Yeah. On what course? Kind of windmills, volcanoes,
come on,
pirates.
Guys. All right, you gonna be social. Let's play nice.
I never shot a 16 on one hole before.
Yeah, well, it was a 14. Sarah, it's a pleasure.
You wanna dance?
I didn't see where it went.
You hooked it. Now you gotta watch your right hand. Let it release. Don't flip it.
Dad, it's getting dark.
Well, I can see just fine. Come on now, let's finish what we started here. One more good one. Come on now.
There you are.
Yeah.
Hey.
Tough day, eh?
Yeah. I've had better.
Yeah, well. I saw you on TV. I gotta say, it was painful to watch.
Try living it.
Believe it or not, I have.
I believe it. I snooped around in your study.
Yeah. Well, I chased the tour for a while. Had my ups and downs. You want an observation? You were playing from back here, see? Tournament golf has to be played in front of you where the target is.
That's a new one.
You have the mechanics, you just don't know what it means to play the game in front of the ball.
I'm debating on picking up a club ever again.
Well, I have a proposition for you. Spend 7 days with me in Utopia. You'll find your game.
I don't know.
Well, take you that long to get your car fixed, you know? So think about it, all right? I'll be at the driving range 9 a.m. tomorrow morning. All right?
Hey, Johnny. I thought you could use some company. Gonna be fireworks soon.
All right.
I also wanted to apologize for Jake. His dad basically disowned him after he chose the rodeo over the family business, so he's got a wounded heart.
That's for sure.
I see. You two together?
No. Everyone expects us to be, but I don't know. Especially Jake.
Oh. Well, what about you?
Me. Mom and I lost my dad to cancer 2 years ago. So I suppose I'm just taking each day as they come.
I'm sorry.
I suppose means God works in mysterious ways.
Johnny says he can help me win my game. Think I should take him up on his offer?
You know what I think? I think some time here might do you good.
Donations appreciated. God bless. Nice.
You got game, son.
You could have told me you owned this place.
Well, you could have told me what really happened to your putter.
What made you want to build a golf course out here?
Well, originally I moved here to get away from the game, but easier said than done, I guess.
So you quit the tour?
Well, the game just wasn't a good fit for me anymore, yeah. Okay, let's get started. I want to see you hit some, all right? Let's see you swing. Come on.
Yeah, these are a little better.
Yep. Why do you grip the club that way?
Well, I don't know. Just feels good.
Well, that's the wrong answer. Now, let's start from scratch, all right? I need to know why you do the things you do. Like the foundation for your swing, from the grip to the follow through. Now go think about it and write it down. The first step in finding a good game is to find some conviction. You got that? Think about it.
How'd I end up here?
Unbelievable.
The toughest challenge you'll face isn't the golf course or even your competitor's score.
It's that casual comment offered by someone, anyone, about how you should be doing it. If you don't have conviction about what your foundation is, that offhanded comment will take you out of your game and erode your confidence. Now, you got that?
Yes, sir. That's Ben Hogan.
Yeah. The one and only.
Place the club in my left hand with my thumb down the shaft. Place my right hand over my left thumb and my lifeline. That helps me cock my wrist and my backswing.
It's good. I do believe.
You're not from here, are you?
Well, not exactly. I lived in a lot of places. Been around here and there within the military. No, I'm not from here.
How'd you end up in Utopia?
You ask a lot of questions, young fella. You really do. I burned all my bridges. There was no place to turn but here.
Tour player like you, players you played with, why here?
I'll tell you. Paul Hawkins was a student of mine way back when. That's Sarah's dad. He's a good man, a great man. He let me stay with him while I got my act together. Been here ever since.
Did you get in some kind of trouble?
It's getting late. I'm gonna see you tomorrow down by the river. Daybreak, all right?
What does the river have to do with golf?
You'll see. You will see.
Rhythm, balance, patience. That's what you need to stay in your game. The same with fly fishing. It takes a calm mindset, a focus on the feel rather than the outcome. It takes emotional control.
Down for?
Well, easy. He took the bait.
Yeah, but why? What made him fall into that trap?
I'm not sure. Because he was hungry?
No. He was mad. I teased him with the shadow casting, never quite letting the fly touch the water. So I was able to take that fish out of his game today. Now, you ready to give it a try? Remember, to stay in balance in the skiff or during your golf swing, you have to control your emotions. Okay?
Breathe, Luke. Rhythm, balance, and patience.
Johnny, I got one.
Now catch it. Keep the tip up. Keep the tip up. Take it as it comes. Right. Easy, easy. Never fails. Good job, son.
Woo!
How come you always seem to do things the hard way?
Yeah.
Hey! I want to show you something. 30 years ago, this man named Jack Nicklaus took me out of my game. You know how? By staying in his game. The calmer he was, the madder I got. And I tried shots I wouldn't ordinarily take. Now, this look familiar?
A little hiccup on 18. Well, at least you got beat by the Golden Bear.
Yeah, and so would you have. Now, tomorrow we actually meet at the course, 5th fairway, 8 a.m.
I'm sorry.
Not good to be late in life, son. Time is too precious to waste.
I said I was sorry.
If this was a tournament, you'd be disqualified. Now, you want to play like a professional, you have to act like one. All right? Now, take a seat. Take a seat. Today, we're going to paint. All right. All golf shots start with a blank canvas. We paint the shot with our eyes first so our bodies can reproduce it accurately. Now, what kind of shot could you make from here?
Well, I think...
No. Don't think. See.
Okay. I see a low punch 8-iron, playing the ball back in my stance with a slightly hooded club face. I can see the ball flying about 30 yards with some hook spin, landing on the upslope of that hill. Bouncing up and going in the cup.
Okay. Now go paint it.
Morning.
Morning.
Jeez. Just paying a visit to Paul.
Yeah.
Hey, Mama. You gonna be all right? Just give me a minute.
Right, honey. You go have fun.
Take care.
I can't believe it's been 2 years.
Yeah. I miss Paul most every day.
Yeah. Oh, ho, ho. Yeah.
Hi.
Hey. You look nice.
Oh, thank you.
So your Uncle Johnny, he's a real piece of work today.
Yeah, well, it's actually kind of a rough day for all of us. It's the 2nd anniversary of Dad's passing. It's okay.
Anything I can do?
Well, I was gonna ask you. My father and I used to go up to Obermeister on his birthday. I was thinking of going out there later today, and I could really use the company.
It'd be an honor.
I see Uncle Johnny's got you painting already.
Yeah, he does. I wasn't expecting that.
Like, we're gonna have to add another shelf.
Yeah, maybe one day there'll be tour trophies on this shelf.
Ain't no maybes in this world, Luke. You understand?
Yes, Dad.
Good. Now rephrase what you just said to me.
Well, one day there will be tour trophies on this shelf.
I'm counting on it, son. I'm proud of you.
You ready, cowboy? Obermeister means masterpiece in Spanish.
I can see why. Sure is beautiful. It might even go as far as call it utopia.
Yeah. Suppose you might.
You ever think of living somewhere else?
But everything I need's right here. I'm free to be myself. Free to do the things I was born to do.
What is that?
Bring freedom to horses. And the occasional stranger.
Here with him.
I'm taking a ride. I don't know. I needed your permission.
So, tour boy, choke on anything lately?
Yeah, well, at least I got a sport to choke on. And what do y'all play out here, mutton busting? You know what us tour boys say about hicks and sheep, don't you?
That's real funny.
I don't know who you think you're talking to.
Hey, quit it! Hey, drag my couple of girls. Jake! Chuck! Get him off!
You heard the lady! Get off me!
Hey. How about you two hotheads settle this over a friendly little game of cowboy poker after the rodeo tonight?
It's time for cowboy poker. Introducing our players, Wayne, Flynn, Pickens, Chuck, Bear, the usual suspect, four-time Utopia rodeo champion, Jake Rustin, and our final player, he's a first-timer, so let's give a warm Utopia welcome for professional golfer Luke Chisholm. All right, boys, deal the cards and let's get this party started.
Time to put up or shut up.
All right, what are we playing?
Texas Hold'em.
Oh, yeah, but there's a catch. You gotta hold on to your chair.
Why?
You'll see.
It's the last man still in their seat, and he wins $200!
Time to go pro?
Well, this hadn't even sunk in yet, so I'm just gonna try to enjoy this feeling, and
he's a humble kid. What he means to say is yes, he will be turning pro. Of course, we'll be turning pro, and we begin looking for a sponsor's exemption immediately.
Yeah, I know. Laugh it up. Hey, speaking of manure, where'd the rhinestone cowboy go? I was ready to gloat.
Well, Jake went off in a huff. He doesn't like to lose.
Yeah, that makes two of us.
Well, it's more life than winning, right?
Like what?
Family. Friendship, faith, love.
Oh, yeah. I guess those two.
All right, Johnny's got the horses hitched up. It's time to go.
You know, cowboy, sometimes I think you might just be hopeless.
Luke. Get in here, Smelly. Come on in here. I hung up your masterpiece. You forgot to sign it.
What's this?
Oh, that bottle's my greatest trophy. No, let me explain. It's the last liquor I ever drank.
Doesn't it tempt you?
No, just the opposite. Makes me remember all the things I lost because I drank too much. That's why I put it there.
Is that why you quit the tour?
Well, more or less, yes. More or less. Pretty hard to drink and drive.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, I'm sorry about this morning being late.
No, I'm not. I am not. Learn how to paint your shot, you learn how to be on time. A professional golfer does both. Now, sign your masterpiece, Picasso. Gonna work on your putting.
Well, the golf course is back that way.
Yeah, it is.
I thought you said we was gonna work on some putt.
That's right. That's right. We are. Come on. I hope you brought some of your winnings from last night. Well played, gentlemen. Well played. Hey, keep practicing.
Well, look who he dragged in here with him. You a little stiff this morning?
Still sore. I beat you last night.
You better watch.
Enough of that, Jake. Knock it off. Hey, Jake, come on, come on. Get the washers, all right? Let's get the game started here. Come on. Same old Jake. Come on. Okay. Now, the rules are simple. A man who's up pitches from behind the marker of his choice.
Yeah, but I don't see what this has to do with golf.
You just watch. Just watch. Just watch. See?
Touchdown! That'll be $5, boys.
You ready to give it a try?
Give me a good day, boys.
Sure. Come on. Don't make me look bad now.
All right. It's on, boys.
Yeah.
Not a chance he'll make this.
You going to put your money where your mouth is?
Oh, I think you're that's on. A bet, Jake.
Oh, dinner's luck.
Woo!
Here, let's see you do that again.
All right. Oh. Yep. Oh. I like this game.
Yeah. Crazy Cowboys. Knock it in, man.
Let's go.
Going to the links now.
I love it.
Gonna go do some putting. Let's go. Come on. Come on. Pitching washers. Give me an idea for a putting technique.
You're kidding, right?
No, sir. I have a respect for tradition, but I have a passion for the truth. Okay? Now, here. Jake?
Yes, sir.
Use a face-on putter. Use a traditional one.
5-1 on Jake.
Say, quiet in the peanut gallery here.
All right. Come on, Jake. Help me out. Get in the hole.
Yes.
Oh. It's gonna be a good day for me.
Good.
Come on, rookie, make me some money.
Oh!
Miss it. Go.
No. No. Yes!
All right. I'm impressed. You ready to give this one a try?
Sure. Here we go. Here we
go. Winning Utopia, right? Come on now. Does this look right?
No way. No way. No yeah. way. No. Oh,
shit. All right. Let me ask you something. Would you or could you use this in competition?
Well, I'd probably get laughed off the course. But it definitely works.
Yeah. No, you keep it. Because when the time comes, you'll know when to use it.
You have any kids?
No, sir. One of my biggest regrets.
I saw your wedding photo.
Oh, you snooping around again, are you? You snooping? You super snooper.
I'm sorry.
You're a real snooper.
Well, that's a cool study room. Pictures of all those legends.
No. Annie, my Annie. Couldn't have kids. She used to joke that she didn't need any because she had me. Yeah.
Well, if you don't mind me asking, what happened?
Well, she's gone on. Couldn't put up with my drinking anymore. Can't say I blame her.
Sorry to hear that.
Gone, but not forgotten. As they say, all part of God's plan. Yeah, I suppose. Good night.
Good night. I'll see you in the morning.
You bet.
Let me guess. This is where you dropped me off in the middle of nowhere. Expect me to get back home with the clothes on my back and two golf tees in my pocket.
That'd be way too easy.
Wow. Is this yours?
Yes, she is.
You're not planning on going up in this thing, though, are you?
Well, why not? I mean, flying's a lot like golf. Eh? Eh?
No. You said fly fishing was a lot like golf.
Did I say that?
Yeah.
All right. Maybe I did. You ready?
No way.
What?
I'm keeping my feet on the ground today.
Oh, yeah?
Whoa! I don't know about this, Johnny. Let's turn back. Your feet control the direction with the rudder. Okay. The stick controls the wings and pitch.
Okay.
Now to turn, you press 1 foot and
yeah.
turn the wheel in that direction.
Turn the wheel direction.
So go up or down, push or pull.
Yeah.
Got it?
Okay. Whoa. Okay.
Okay, no hands. See, like this. You're going to do it.
All right, I'm getting it now. I'm getting it. I think I'm getting it.
Like riding a horse. Keep her steady.
What just happened?
What, Johnny?
Hold on.
What happened to the propeller?
We have an emergency.
Whoa,
plane down.
Johnny, you take.
You take control of this aircraft, son. All right?
I don't know what to do.
Keep the nose down and level the wind. All right? Okay. All right.
You're doing great.
All right.
How's that?
Right now, it's good.
We should try to go back, shall we?
We can't get back. We'll have to find a place around here.
Come on.
There's a wheat field.
All right, good.
You're doing great, son. Keep your wits about you, okay?
Level your wings. You got 500 feet to go.
How about that?
Yeah. You're doing great.
Steady.
Bring it in.
Steady.
Keep your wings level.
Okay.
All right.
Leveling my wings. Is this good? We good?
Yeah, great. You're doing great.
Leveling.
Bring it in. Well, coming in.
Wait, what happened here? Goodness me.
What? The engine was turned off. Did you turn the engine off?
The engine's turned off.
your idea of a thief joke?
Why are you laughing? Oh, confidence comes with being prepared, my son, as it go over life hand in hand.
I'm about to throw up over here.
You can't play in a tournament unless you're ready for the unexpected on game day.
Smells delicious.
Mabel's Trout's famous around here.
More famous than her pies?
Couldn't be more famous. As famous, maybe, but more famous.
For food in a world where many walk in hunger, for faith in a world where many walk in fear, for friends in a world where many walk alone. We give you thanks, O Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
He definitely puts the game first.
Reminds me of someone else I used to know.
That he does. Hopefully he finds his way quicker than me.
Hey. Hey there, stranger.
Hey.
So, when's the last time you caught a firefly?
Well, I don't know. Since I was a little kid.
Well, that's too long. Come on.
She has Paul's gift.
She always was a daddy's girl.
Hey, Sarah.
What?
These ones in here quit making light.
Well, that's because they know they're trapped. It makes their lights go out. Freedom's a powerful force.
It's gonna rain. Ready for today's lesson?
I can only imagine what you got in store for me today.
Yes, sir. Today we play golf.
Good. What should I hit, driver?
No. Today, we visit the history of the game and its future. You're gonna be playing with hickory sticks and a face-on putter.
Ooh, not bad.
Perfect. SFTA. One for you. See it, feel it, trust it.
Little butter cut over at left tree.
How far?
About 310.
210.
What's the course record?
Well, you ever shot a 59? You keep playing this way, you just might. Weather permitting, of course.
Nothing stopping me. I'm seeing it, feeling it, and trusting it.
Come
That's the time start made, see?
We got one more hole.
No. 59. Doesn't matter, Luke.
Well, it matters to me.
That's not the lesson. That was never the lesson.
You spent the whole week teaching me how to play the best golf of my life. Now I'm playing it.
All right. Well, you don't have to prove anything to me, Luke. Because I'm not your father.
You don't know anything about my dad, so back off.
Oh, you can't spend your life trying to validate yourself with a golf score.
Well, how would you know? It looks to me like you quit on your dream, living out here in this godforsaken goat ranch.
And this is your dream today? This is your dream?
I'm sorry, Johnny.
I forgive you, son.
Whose grave you digging?
You'll soon see. What's yours gonna say? Your epitaph, your headstone. What do you want people to say about you when you're gone? Huh? Maybe they'll say you shot a 59.
I never thought of it like that.
Maybe we'll just leave it blank for now.
No, I mean, I'd wanted to say, something.
It will. But I don't think that your coming here was an accident. But only you can decide what to do from here on out. I mean, nothing more I can teach you, son.
Thank you, Johnny.
Okay. You thank me. Thank him. Because God is all around us, inside of each of us, if you listen. There's a still small voice of truth leading us, talking to us, and telling you that you can see God's face, feel his presence, trust his love. Yeah. SFT.
SFT.
God bless you. Happy Easter.
Luke, inside this box is a pencil and two pieces of paper. One is for writing down all the truths you've learned during your time here in Utopia. The truth that life is about faith, relationships, character, and integrity. That God has a purpose and calling for you that is much deeper than a little white ball falling into the cup. These truths will become your new heartbeat, the foundation of your new life. The other piece of paper is for writing down all the lies you've been told during your life. Lies like your golf score being a reflection of your true identity and self-worth, or that failure in golf is failure in life. Take the truths with you, but bury the lies right here, right now. Once you have buried your lies, chisel your living epitaph.
Today I found myself, after searching all these years, and the man that I saw, he wasn't at all who I thought he'd be. Well, I was lost when you found me here. Well, I was broken beyond repair. Then you came along and you sang your song over me. It feels like I'm born again. It feels like I'm living for the very first time. I'm living for the first time. It feels like I'm born.
Ready to go, are we?
Yeah, I think so.
Don't think. See, feel, trust. Yeah. Now,
before you leave, I have something for you. I need something, man.
Well, you've given me more than I could repay, sir.
Well, gifts aren't meant to be repaid. They're meant to be passed along. Look at this. That was my last tournament. You notice anything?
Oh. Well, you're not on the leaderboard.
Well, yeah, that, but no, look again, look again, look.
Oh, it's the Texas Open.
Right.
That's this weekend.
Yeah. Now, the tournament's main sponsor is an old friend. He says it's a personal favor. He'll offer you one of his free exemptions.
Well, man. Well, I don't know what to say.
Well, I think between you and me, it's all about the ratings. He's probably hoping you have another meltdown, and I'm hoping that you can prove him wrong.
Yeah. Well, you can count on it.
Now, don't go running over any of them cows, because I don't want you to ruin my pie.
Well, don't worry. I can see a little better now.
Yeah, you can. Okay. God bless you, son.
God bless you.
Oh, I'm gonna miss you.
I'm gonna miss y'all, too. Thank you so much for everything.
You bet.
you a little gift. Just keep the lid off it and come visit whenever you want.
Well. Till next time, then.
Next time.
Need any more putting lessons, you just let me know. The tour boy.
Well, if you need some lessons on some cowboy poker, well, you're just gonna have to figure it out yourself.
Johnny.
Yeah.
Thank you for everything.
No. I want to thank you for everything. I really do.
Let's get you something to eat.
Yes, Mom.
Hey, what? I got you a little present. Callaway's latest and greatest.
Thanks, Dad.
Luke, my actions last week were wrong. I pushed you your whole life to succeed at golf. I never once asked if that's what you wanted. I'm sorry for that.
Well, I forgive you.
I only want what's best for you.
I know. I love you, Dad.
I love you, son. Well, you ain't looked at mine in a while. Might be overdue. Good night, son. Welcome on.
Hey, Dad. I almost forgot. You want a caddy for me this week in the Texas Open?
Welcome, everyone, to the pride of the Lone Star State, the Valero Texas Open.
I'm Kelly Tillman with PGA Tour winner Brandel Chamblee. A compelling story this week. Brandel is the sponsor invite, Luke Chisholm.
How does one go from oblivion to center stage? This man knows, Kelly. In his first PGA Tour event, he has a chance for redemption.
Now on the first tee from Waco, Texas, Luke Chisholm.
Round 2 and 3 saw heated action atop the leaderboard. Some of golf's biggest names pining for the lead. Rich Beam, Stuart Sink, TKO, and Ricky Fowler.
This pressure-filled Sunday at the Texas Open offers an abundance of characters. Stuart Sink, four-time Masters champ TKO, and we have a local talent with fresh wounds.
The surprise performance coming from Luke Chisholm, just 2 weeks removed from that complete meltdown at the Lone Star event in San Antonio. And now he finds himself chasing, of all people, TKO atop the leaderboard. And Kelly, you really couldn't script it any better than this.
No, you can't, Brandel. We've seen Cinderella stories before, but we've also seen what TKO has done to those glass slippers. He has crushed them.
And we pick up with Luke Chisholm now on the 10th tee.
Let's hit three wood. Fairway's a little tight.
Chisholm playing it safe here with the three wood on this very reachable par five.
That shot will very likely put some demons in his head. It was a shot almost identical to that started his monumental blow-up a few weeks ago.
Luke's gonna have to conquer those demons if he wants to win, and that is one of the toughest things to do in golf.
Well, what you want to do, son?
Go back to the tee. Well, it's gonna be one heck of a par, Dad.
Ah, you got it.
Having taken an unplayable lie on his first drive, Chisholm is now back on the tee, hitting his third shot.
Looks like he's going with the driver this time, Brandon.
And Kelly, I don't know why he didn't use driver the first go-around. He hasn't sniffed missing a tee shot all week long with that Callaway Octane driver.
Clubhouse boys, y'all play well.
A par after taking an unplayable could be a turning point for Chisholm.
This Sunday has given us a great leaderboard. Rich Beam capable of a big charge, question marks surrounding Luke Chisholm, and TKO as intimidating as ever.
But it looks like we're winding down to just two, a classic David and Goliath story between Chisholm and TKO. Chisholm from 12 feet, and he sinks it. Luke Chisholm just one back at TKO.
You know he's licking his chops right here, not only to make birdie, but to put the pressure on TKO to do the same and avoid a playoff.
Remember, TKO eagled this hole yesterday.
And now Luke Chisholm with his second shot to this par four of the 18th hole.
Yeah.
The pressure is really on TKO now. He has no choice but to go for the green. This one's looking good, Brandel. It's on the green with a chance at eagle.
He makes it look easy, doesn't he, Kelly?
What an answer by the steely veteran TKO, who drove the green. If he makes this eagle putt, he wins. And how's this for excitement? TKO and Chisholm are headed to a playoff, both men tied at 16 under.
And TKO has the upper hand once again. He's never been defeated in a playoff on the PGA Tour, and Luke Chisholm, his first taste in extra holes.
We're going back to the 18th tee where anything can happen. TKO and Luke Chisholm are about to tee off on one of the greatest risk-reward holes in all of golf. And earlier, Brandel had a chance to take a closer look at this tremendous finishing hole.
The finishing hole here is a great one. A drivable par 4 of 355 yards that plays downhill and gives the players a lot of choices. But those choices come with risks. The green is protected by a tree and a bunker and a treacherous water hazard. The green itself is very narrow and fast, with a lot of sloping, and a two-putt from above the hole is highly unlikely. But one of the worst places that a player could drive the ball would be long and to the left in that area there, because an up and down would be almost impossible. And his pitch shot would most likely run off the front of the green.
And there you have it, folks. This hole provides the perfect stage for the drama that's about to unfold.
Well, no surprise here, folks. TKO has taken driver out, obviously trying to make an eagle and win this thing outright, but in doing so, he brings double bogey into play. TKO lives for moments like this.
And TKO is one of perhaps just 10 players who can drive this screen. We saw him do it just moments ago in regulation. Oh, it sounds like he crushed that one.
Yeah, it's a good-looking swing. Always in balance. It took off on the right line. But there's more wind now than there was earlier. He's getting more help, and with his high ball flight, carrying that creek should not be a problem. But holding this green will be.
Well, look at this. This could be serious trouble. That's the danger zone Brandel was just describing. Luke Chisholm going with the conservative play, iron off the tee.
Yeah, no surprise there, Kelly. He's stuck to that game plan all week, and with only one exception, has he strayed from the fairway. He's looking to put this ball in a spot where he gets the right number, gets a wedge in his hand, and he can put the pressure on TKO.
Is this the same player from 2 weeks ago?
No, it's not the same player. He may have the same swing, but a completely different outlook.
What we got? 75 yards. Just like in regulation.
Yeah.
Lob way. Good. Thank you.
This is the same shot he had just a few moments ago. However, the situation is entirely different. He knows that given TKO's lie, he could win this tournament, whereas a few moments ago, he was chasing.
See it, feel it, and trust it.
Not quite like his hole-out regulation, but under the circumstances, a very solid shot.
If TKO was looking for a gift from an inexperienced Luke, he didn't get it.
TKO has a nearly impossible pitch. He's looking at a tight flag. The green is running away from him, not to mention the water. Anything short of hitting that flag stick, and he's probably going swimming.
Yeah, plain and simple here, Kelly. He needs to play away from the hole, and it's a pretty safe bet that he's going to have a longer birdie putt than Luke's eight-footer.
The ultimate test for TKO, but I wouldn't put it past him. He's done it before.
Look at the way he's sizing this up. It almost looks like, and he is, I think, going to go right at this hole. It absolutely makes no sense to me. If he doesn't hole this, very likely that this ball is going to run off of the green.
And this would really be something. And he's got to aim right for the flagstick. Anything short of perfect here, he's looking at bogey at best. That's if he's lucky enough to avoid the water.
The only way to pull this shot off on that line is with a lot of speed, a lot of spin, and he has to land it in an area about as big as a dinner plate.
And it looks good. It's got a chance.
Lucky, Kelly, that that ball didn't go in, but lucky that it stayed on the green and gave him about a 15-foot putt up the hill, and maybe he could put the pressure on Luke.
And look at him. He's not even fazed. This is a makeable putt for TKO. Is this where experience pays off?
Generally speaking, first in a playoff wins, and if he makes this, I promise you, that hole will look a lot smaller to Luke.
How many times has TKO been in this exact spot and emerged victorious? It's that mental edge that makes him the great player that he is. Ooh, he thought he had that one.
TKO's tee shot left him with a lot of stress. His second shot left him with a lot of work. Now it's Luke who has the work to do, and TKO no longer has control of his own fate. That control lies with Luke Chisholm.
It was a great par for TKO just to stay in it. But now, the door is open for Luke Chisholm to win the Texas Open.
One can only imagine what's going on in the mind of Luke Chisholm right now. 2 weeks ago, his career was over, and now, he is one putt away from taking the Texas Open and beating the best player in golf in the process.
Luke knew this putt was meaningless in the big picture. He was now answering to a higher calling. It was time to go to a place beyond tradition, to a place of buried lies and unearthed truths. A revolution had begun within Luke's soul. He had a purpose and a calling that went beyond any scoreboard. Saw, felt, trusted, and stroked the putt of his life. You Utopia is defined as a place of mythical perfection. But I knew differently. Utopia is indeed real. It's a place where the voice of truth resides and eternal trophies line the shelves. A place where there are no accidents. I guess you're asking yourselves whether or not he made the putt. Better question is, does it really matter? How can a game have such an effect on a man's soul?
To your side.